Day two, and it's pretty windy on top of my little takeoff from the northeast, but it's supposed to be dropping. At the moment, there's absolutely no way. Anyway, I'm about to walk down to the shepherd's hut and go and grab a coffee and meet up with the other three guys. And we are on a pretty nice hill, somewhere to the sort of northeast of Corps, and all getting ready to take off within the next 15-20 minutes. And the plan is fly from here straight over onto those slopes in the sun there, and hopefully they'll be on a bit of hitting a bit of valley wind, get up high, ending up somewhere near Albertville with a bit of luck. Only got two locusts in it. All right, bon vol. Okay, I'm gonna go for it. Well, let's hope this works. Otherwise, it's a trip down there. And the answer is, it's working. Woohoo! We've got Mincek and Rich down there. Steve hasn't taken off yet, which is a bit worrying. Wonderful. 2130. He just got so close to me. Can't have been more than 5 feet. Oh, shame I didn't have a camera. Rich and Mincek making good progress. Steve has crossed the valley, but it looks like he's pinned in a headwind, the valley wind there. Not sure he's going to be going up at all. Unfortunately, Steve has somehow got himself in the trees, and we don't know exactly where. I've sent him an in-reach message. There's no point in us landing until we've spotted him. Absolutely nothing we can do from the ground if we can't see him. I'm going to get high again so I can carry on trying to spot him from higher up. Rich, can you see his flarm on your display? Over. Right, I think I can see him. Yeah, I'm more or less over him now.
I think I know roughly where you are, but I just can't get down.
So Steve is okay, he does not need help, so
Richard and Mincek and I will push on. Okay, we're pretty much finally out of this bowl. It'll be a bit nicer on these green slopes. Scratchy stuff. We've got this high cover just come in and it's killing everything. If we can just stay up till it passes, or if I, Rich has gone on glide, so has Mincek. Finally, I found a reasonable climb. It's not the fastest, it's only about a meter per second, or 1.5, but at least it's been consistent. So I'm up at 2-2 and the sky has changed. We've got this band of cloud. If I can just stay up, get high and then cross to there, the sun might be on it by the time I'm there. But I want to get as high as possible here first. Yeah, so I've got up to 2450. Pretty much at base, as you can see. Locally at least. And that's hopefully enough to get me onto those slopes now. Rich has landed. Don't know about Mincek yet. Just coming round into a interwind slope. I hope I can just get round it. Meters. Let's see if miracles will happen. Up at 2,000 meters again. Really sweet climb now. 2.5 to 3. A nice cumulus at the top of this hill. Very tricky getting past that little village though. Scratch-tastic. But this is gorgeous. Right, that's it for now. Oh, this is a bit horrible. massive valley ahead. This is landings. Valley wind will be blowing up it. Landings down there. I think I'll just sort of head across there and then I'll try and bail out there if necessary. Trying to get to St-André-les-Alpes for the morning. Difficult. Lisa and I had a meal in this town ahead 2 years ago. Can't remember what it's called. Massive big chateau, as you can see. Just trying to get around the corner here. Quite a headwind. So I made it around the corner and I'm on half bar, just going up nicely into a bit of a crosswind. But making good progress. Well, not the fastest, but getting out of that horrible little choke point there. Next obstacle, some massive cables. If I can get under these clouds, that'll be pretty nice. Decided to head for St-André-les-Alpes for the evening. I'm obviously not going to get across to it. I won't be able to land there, but I'll try and get there, try and hitch up. I can see the road going up to it there. And it's all clouded over, as you can see, so I'm not really going to get much further. But what a flight! Fantastic fun. How many hours? Almost 4 hours. A lot of that actually was obviously spent faffing around there, making sure Steve was okay, which I'm very pleased to say he is. That's Grenoble there, obviously. Okay, I've got to look out for aircraft now. Well, I found quite a nice little climb. It's getting stronger. Very little drift. It would be amazing if I did actually land at St-André-les-Alpes. Who knows? Who knows? Let's just concentrate and stay in this. That's 1.9 too. So that's St-André-les-Alpes over there. I'm sort of about the same level as it, but can't see me making it. Unless there's some miracle, in which case I have to land by the road which goes up there, so I have to land in one of those fields down there. Okay, this is it. I can see a windsock in a field down there. So that is clearly a landing field. Let's get down. What a fun flight. Well done, glider. What a machine. What a flight. Really good fun. Just marred, obviously, by Steve's little incident with the tree, but he's fine. He's back on comms. And I think we're all going to try and rendezvous up here.